On this week's Essential API of the Week, we take a look at battery, giving you information to, you guessed it, battery information of your device. So tune in. Welcome back to Essential API of the Week. Today, we're taking a look at battery information from the battery API in Xamarin Essentials, enabling us to get access to the actual power usage, like how much battery is left, how your device is being charged, and even register for notifications. So let's hop over and get started. Now, the first place we need to go to get started is in our documentation. Xamarin Essentials gives you everything you need to get started with our Getting Started guide. Right here, this will give you access to know what platform Xamarin Essentials supports, how to install the NuGet package, and of course, any additional setup for Android, iOS, or Windows 10. Now, for Android, you're gonna need to add a few lines of code to initialize Xamarin Essentials, but that's it. The greatest part here is on the left-hand side or on the main Xamarin Essentials documentation, you'll find access to all of the different APIs. So let's take a look at battery. Now, let's say we're building an application where we need to maybe upload a big image or do some background processing, or maybe I'm doing some navigation. The battery API can come in nifty because I can detect when my user's device has low battery left or is even on energy saver mode. So I can enable different parts of my UI based on this. So some important parts here to get started. For Android, we need to add a little bit of a permission state to get access to the battery. We'll go ahead and copy that to the clipboard. For iOS and UWP, no additional setup required. Now, what's great here is that I can learn about the API. So here, directly from the battery API, I can get access to the charge level, state, power source, and more. I can subscribe to notifications and even get access to that energy saver status. So let's go into our application and go ahead and enable this. So here I am inside of Visual Studio. I've gone ahead and installed Xamarin Essentials into my shared code and my iOS and my Android application. Now inside of Android, I've added that initialization code that I showed you from the documentation. Inside of my assembly info, I can go ahead and paste that permission that I need for the battery stats. Here I'm also using some additional permissions such as network state. And now what we can do is start to build out a page for battery information. So let's take a look at what I've done here. It's very simplistic. All I have is a stack layout and a label that says nothing at this point. And I'll put the battery level here of what we're outputting. So let's integrate the battery information into this app. In the code behind, we'll start by using Xamarin.Essentials, like the documentation said. Now, inside of here, I've done a little helper method that sets the background based on a double that's passed in and if we're charging or not. So here, for instance, I want to set the background color to green at a certain alpha based on the level. If it's over 50%, or if it's above 10%, I'll set it to yellow, or red if it's in the final 10%. Then I'll simply set the background color. So we need to get access to that information from the battery. So what we can do here, if I go ahead and zoom in, is I could, of course, write Xamarin.Essentials. And get access to every single API, such as battery. Or I can just simply type battery and get access to the battery info, the charge level, energy status, power source, and state of it. So let's call that set background. Here it's going to ask for the level. So we'll say battery.charge level. And then here, we can also say if it's charging or not. So we can do this by say battery.state, and we can check to see if it is charging or not. There we go. It's simple as that, just to pass in that state and the level with just a few lines of code. But of course, we want to update this in real time based on the charge level change, so we can add an event. So here I'll say battery.batteryInfoChanged, and we'll go ahead and pass in a new method that will be called automatically on appearing. And then on disappearing, we're just going to go ahead and unsubscribe that event. Now, you guessed it. Whenever I get that event, I'll get some battery info changed event arguments that I can pass in. So here I can say set background. And instead of passing in the battery info dot, I already have it by using those arguments. I can then, of course, come in and say, am I charging? And if so, I'll say e.state equals equals charging. There we go. Just a few lines of code, not only to get access to the battery information, but also to register for an event. So now all I need to do is simply run this application. So let's go ahead and compile this and see what it looks like in the running application. Now I've gone ahead and ran this application on iOS and Android, and I have given myself access here through this little hamburger menu. And here we go. I have some battery information that's coming in. Now one thing to note, and then we have documented, is that I'm not able to get the battery information on iOS unless I run it on a physical device. So be aware that inside of the documentation, this will tell you. The Android emulator, on the other hand, will actually give me this information. So that's why I'm not seeing anything on iOS. Over on Android, I can come in and actually tap on the extended controls, and I can change that charge level, and we're getting that information in real time. I can say that this is not charging at all, and I get that update too. There we go. So with just a few lines of code, we're able to get that. And I would get the same effect if I ran this on iOS on the physical device. With that same API, I'm able to get access to that battery information with just a few lines of code. I can, of course, come back in to the application and get access to other things, such as that power source, which will be, for instance, if it's on battery, USB, or wireless. And additionally, the battery information will tell me if I'm on an energy saver status here. And I can go ahead and compare that to see if I'm on, off, or unknown, so I can modify my application in real time. And there you have it. In just a few lines of code, we integrated battery information into our application with Xamarin Essentials. Tune in to more Essential APIs of the Week by subscribing on YouTube or Channel 9, and thanks for watching.